Hello students, welcome to e-tutions. In the previous lectures we had discussed about continuous beam. Today from this lecture we will discuss about the slope deflection method. Slope deflection method. This is one of the method which will be used not to find out the fixed end moments for a continuous beams by using the slope deflection method. This slope deflection method, it was introduced by G.A. Manny is a researcher. He had introduced this method, slope deflection method, in order to solve the continuous beams in 1915. In 1915, he had started using this, he had proposed this slope deflection method in order to solve the fixed end moments and deflections by using this method, and he had found out the fixed end moments by using this slope deflection method. In this, if you consider in a member, if the slopes at the ends on the relative displacements of the ends are known, then the moments at the ends, it can be found by using of the slopes, displacements and stiffness of the member. In this, it is mostly dependent on the terms slopes, displacements and stiffness of the member. Suppose we can represent the stiffness of the member as some k. So by using this we will find out the we will use these terms in order to solve by using the slope deflection method. In this method the clockwise movements at the ends are taken as positive, whereas anti-clockwise movements at the ends are taken as negative. So like this we will consider, suppose if there is a fixed beam which is having a certain span and the anti-clockwise movement, it is taken as negative, and the clockwise movement at the fixed end, you will take it as positive. Okay, and next one is the slope, it is taken as positive. Suppose I am considering again a fixed beam and it is possessing a certain deflection like this, and here I am drawing a tangent for this. When I had drawn a tangent for this, there is a slope made by this. Suppose this is theta 1 and this is theta 2. These are the slopes which are made at the fixed ends. Suppose if you consider this slope, this is moving in this direction, so this will be like this. In this, the displacement of the right end with respect to the left end, if it will be downwards, it will be taken as positive. Suppose I am considering if a fixed beam like this. Suppose on the other end, if the displacement on this with respect to the left end, the displacement at the right end, the displacement is like this, then it will be considered as a positive displacement. Similarly, if the beam which will be having the displacement like this and it will be having some negative displacement, that means the displacement, it will be present upwards, then you can take it as a negative displacement. This will be the negative displacement. So this will be the cases. And in this, the angle made by the line with x-axis in positive direction, then the tangent of the line to that angle, it will be called as a slope of a line. So, okay, in this, if you consider the angle which is made by this line, suppose I had told you in the particular fixed beam, which will be possessing a certain amount of deflection, for this, in the x-axis in positive direction, the tangent of the line to that angle, suppose this is the angle which is possessed and this is the line, and this line we call it as the slope of the line. And the axis of the beam, when it is loaded or unloaded, we call it as the elastic line. In this, suppose if you consider a beam, and this is the axis of the beam, this particular axis, whether it is being loaded or unloaded, suppose if it is unloaded, it will be like this. If it is loaded, you will get the beam deflected like this. And this centers, we call it, this center lines, we call it as the elastic line. This line, we call it as the elastic line of the beam. Okay. And these are the basic information which you need to know before undergoing first law of deflection method. And now we will discuss how can we undergo by using slope deflection equations. Hope students you had understood up to now. In the coming lecture we will discuss about what is meant by slope deflection equation and how we can solve the fixed beams by using the slope deflection equations, that we will discuss. And in this I would like to tell you, in this we will discuss about with joint translations and without joint translations in the fixed beam by using slope deflection method. First of all, we will discuss about without joint translations. Thank you for listening this lecture.